morning, good afternoon, and good evening. My name is Dustin. I am a subject matter expert in the systems management space. Today, I'll be going over in-band discovery of Windows operating systems using OpenManage Enterprise. OME uses OpenSSH to discover Windows servers. Windows 2019 and later versions that will have SSH available by default. I will show you how to enable this for discovery with OME. First thing you have to do is go to settings. I'm already there, but just to show you, you go to settings, then you go to apps, and then you choose manage optional features. From here, you want to make sure that OpenSSH client and OpenSSH server are installed. Normally, OpenSSH server is not installed by default. In order to add it, you would just click add a feature, find it on the list, and you would choose install. Since it's already on mine, we won't have to do that. We'll skip that step. The next thing you're going to want to do is make sure that the services for that are started and set to automatic. So let's find that OpenSSH service. This one is not started. And it's automatic. I believe it's manual by default. So make sure that it is set to automatic so when the server restarts, they can still have communication to it from OME. So now that OpenSSH server service is started in automatic, OpenSSH server is installed, we want to make sure we have a firewall rule in place to allow SSH. Here is the firewall rule and what it looks like. It's port 22, and we allow the connection. So next, we're going to want to go to OME and see what happens when we try to discover it. So let's create a discovery job. We'll call it in band. We will choose server, and we will pick Windows since that is what we have. Don't get confused by Hyper-V. All this is saying is that you can do Windows or Hyper-V or both. Put in your IP address and your SSH credentials, which should most likely be the same as your NT credentials. In this case, we're just using administrator. And we're going to go ahead and run now, and let's finish. See if this queues, completes, fails, and regardless of what it does, we will see what happens. So now that this is completed, let's view the details, take us to the job page and show us the steps. And if we see the actual results here, there it is. All right, so we are completed. It does show success, but it does say artifacts are not available, so we need to run the inventory task. This is actually just a normal next step. So let's go to devices and see if it even shows up. Yep, it's right there, and it tells me that it's now showing the, it's correlating my two devices. We have a Windows server and an iDRAC server. They're both the same server. So now let's go ahead and go to inventory. We're going to create an inventory task, Windows in band. We're going to choose just our Windows servers. We're going to collect driver inventory. So what is this going to do? What it's going to do is it's going to install either Dell support or it's going to install inventory collector. So Dell system update, not Dell support, sorry. Dell system update or inventory collector. And that's how it's going to get the inventory as well as how we'll push the drivers in the future. So let's take a look at how that goes. Okay, now that Windows in-band inventory that I created has completed, let's look at the details. And it looks like it's updating inventory collector and Dell system updates. So basically it's installing those on the target machine. It then runs the inventory from the inventory collector that it got. And now it has inventory. At this point, everything is discovered, happy, and in place and ready for driver updates or just simple monitoring. That's it. I hope you enjoyed my video on in-band Windows discovery with OME. Thank you very much and have a great day.